edition of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, Robert, how you doing, man?
Yes, and thank you for taking my call. I wanted to let you know that I've been a subscriber for a couple of years, just different members of your team, and I really enjoy it. But really the reason I'm calling is to express my sincerest gratitude for you providing that information yesterday on the small business grant. I'm a small business owner and primary breadwinner for my family, and if I can get that money, it's going to really mean a lot to my family. So
that's awesome.
Thank you for taking the time to do that.
No, well, listen, man, we appreciate you growling a problem with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night and a great year, folks. Always do your best. Take action on your ideas. This is going to be a good one, folks, for kicking into the new year. Doing your best means to take action on your ideas. You can have many great ideas in your head, but without action upon an idea, there'd be no manifestation, no results, and no reward. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 116, NASDAQ is down 80, S&P's down 3, gold contract down $1.30, trading at $18.07 an ounce. We have silver up 13 cents, $23.11 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 36 cents, $75.94 a barrel, notes and bonds. The 10-year note up 2 ticks, trading 130.20. The 30-year down 3 at 160.21 in King Dollar. King Dollar right now is up 98 ticks, trading out at 96.191. The euro is at 113. The yen is at 114.81. And the British pound is at 134 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in y'all world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at it. What do you have? So if we take a look at the SPY, what we had out here yesterday, folks, is this. You broke topside. The break topside is saying that the SPY wants to go to 450. And where I get that, folks, is that all you're doing is that I'm taking the consolidation that was in place. You take the width of the consolidation, which is 25 points, you add it on to the top. Bottom line, you get approximately 498 to 500. So we'll see how this baby shakes out. The thing that's pretty wild, when you do look at the S&P, the last time we did this, we did the exact same thing. And you're going to see when we consolidated from the price from the time of September 2nd going all the way over to this 25th, it was the same number. It actually came up right to the same number, meaning that consolidation brought you up to the 473, and we'll see how this baby shakes out. You know, it makes sense to me today that you're going sideways and the market couldn't hold higher price. Why? Because when you get that much acceleration on the way up, bottom line, takes a huge amount of energy. Normally, you go sideways for a few days after that. When I take a look at the Qs, what you have with the Qs is this. The Qs got to 404 today. You're trading down 165. But the way this is set up, this is not going away from these highs. That's what it looks like to me. Closing high in the Qs was 403.99. So it looks like we may be underneath that today. But bottom line, when you're looking at this, this tells me that the Qs also want to go into its high, which is the 408 number. Small caps. Let's take a look at the small caps, the IWM. We go take a look at the Russell 2000 using the small caps. So we have the small caps. That also went to its swing point. Couldn't handle price, 225. You're at 223. Bottom line, that looks to me is going higher also. You get over the highs. You're going to be underneath them. This is going to build some cause, I suspect, to at least get into that gap, which is the 228 area. Gold contract out here. We have with the gold contract. Didn't hold price again. We got up to a price point of 1821. I'm just curious. I wanted to see this. I was listening to Basil. Oh, good. Okay, so the gold contract's over the 200-day moving average. I don't use moving averages, folks, but it's always good to basically take a look at them. So they're all under it. The contract itself was over the 200. So bottom line is that, you know, my take on gold, folks, we're going to 1925. And we'll see how this baby shakes out. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? We take a look at King dollar, and that's still a sideways move, slightly higher. And, you know, King dollar's been on a toss-up. Every day is just, you know, consolidating, going basically at the higher end of the consolidation or the lower end. When I do look at the euro, it looks to me like the euro's getting off the low, has been building a base. And if that's the case, the bottom line is that the euro can make this run up to 116. That'd be saying that the dollar would go back to its breakout area. So, you know, the euro is 60% of the dollar index. And when we take a look at it, you can see quite clearly, you can just flip the dollar one around. And what do you have? You have the bottom line, the exact same setup. The difference is the dollar's at high, the euro's at low. Notes and bonds. We take a look at the note and bond market out here. 10-year note. This has also been going sideways. It has light volume. They're all going to be light volume this week. You get 10 years up by two ticks. You're at 130.20. And we are right now 1.47. 1.47 is your yield on that 10-year. We go take a look at TWI. This is Titan. I believe this is a big tire company. Yeah, Titan International. Okay, so this is up 67 cents. The low is $4.68. The high is $11.82. They come out with their numbers March 4th. Okay, and so the question is, do you see it pulling back? Okay, so this has been quite a move. In 5 days, we've gone from a price point of $7 to $10.81. Let me just look at something. What I can tell you is this. This is the type of move, okay, that you normally get in the commodity market. That's how this works. You got to be patient with it, and then once the move comes, they're straight line moves, man. You know, so the question is, do I see a pullback? And I don't see a pullback until this gets up to the highs. Because what you have here is that you get the long price bars. When you get long price bars and you're going after a swing point, most of the time it just goes for the whole deal. I just want to see if anyone's really buying this thing. Okay, so we're in December. I don't have any new buys right there. No, I don't have any new buys. But the bottom line is that is one strong stock. There's no two ways about that. That is quite a move, man. Holy cow. Well, actually, let's look at this here. So let's do it this way. We put it on a weekly because I think it broke out of consolidation. When you break out of consolidations, it can get pretty intense, meaning that's the building cause. Okay, so... Oh, yeah, I took it out. So you had the consolidation on. Last high was 1182. You get down to 675. And 675 here, watch this. This gets interesting because this was only a 0.382 retracement. Oh, well, no, it was just over. It was about a 45% retracement from the move off the bottom. You know? Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Come right back, folks.
Are you looking for a way to consistently add winning trades to your portfolio? Tom O'Brien is here to help. Tom O'Brien has been successfully trading markets for over 30 years. A frequent contributor to TD Ameritrade Network and CNBC, Tom O'Brien founded TFNN over 20 years ago to help educate investors just like you. Tom's daily market newsletter, Market Insights, is published every morning when the markets open to give you the competitive informational edge you need to succeed. These newsletters are packed full of Tom's advanced technical analysis and are geared to deliver comprehensive strategies for a successful portfolio. Get Tom O'Brien's newsletter, Market Insights, today and try all of our products and newsletters 30 days risk-free with our money-back guarantee at TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TESS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TESS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE, and you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow Industrials right now are trading up 115. We get the Nasdaq down 74. S&Ps are off 3.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday. And don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 10 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter. Now, it's very easy to get his newsletter. You come over to TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content, the opening call. You just hit the opening call. You're going to hit subscribe. You can get the newsletter for 1 month for $149. You can get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 at 22%. And you can get it for 1 year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 at 33%. Now, folks, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. You like it? Great. You keep it. For some reason, it doesn't work for you? Guess what? Just tell us you want your money back. No problem. Basil, in particular, has approximately 10 to 12 archives on his site. So the bottom line, once you get it, you're going to understand how to look at this market, how to ride that Chapman wave every single day. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Very good. Thank you.
Cool, man. So we get a market, huh?
We always have a market. And the interesting thing here is I had mentioned to you, I think last week, that what I'm looking at closely and what we've been looking at for months now is how so many stocks come back to within pennies of their previous high and then start to pull back again. And we're looking at the Dow at 36,565 all-time high on the 8th of November. Drops all the way down to the 200-period moving average exactly, gets to the 34,022 level, spikes up to 36,189, pulls back very sharply to the 34,715 area, and then has almost like an A to B equals C to D, although in the Chapman wave we call it leg C, a move to the upside. And what is the high today? 36,527. It is unbelievable. It's within 40 points of the all-time high, and this is weeks and weeks later. So I've considered that this is a pattern that I need to be cognizant of going into the end of the year. One of the things I spoke about all the way back in October, as I said, if the Dow, especially the Dow, but if the Dow closes in November, in last week of October, the first week of November, close to the yearly high, then there's a really good chance that somehow, some way, it closes pretty close to that level by the end of the year. that's been the history. Just that's from my memory. I didn't actually go back and check it out, but that's just my memory. So we are very close. We've got a couple of days to go, and I'm watching these potential double tops. Now, the S&P, I should also mention that we have very good technicals actually in this leg C. In the Chapman wave, we're always looking for at least a D. You saw this peak D right here in the weekly chart. But most importantly is I've got a lagging on balance volume. Stochastic has finally gotten over 80% to 85%. That's a good sign. The MACD is good. The 90 is over the 14. So it's really going to be bad news or something that comes up very suddenly if there's going to be another sharp drop. But I'm anticipating that we have some kind of a pullback in the next day or so. Then we do go to this leg D. And that's where I think we've got to be careful again. And one of the reasons I say that is, look, here's the S&P. This is the daily chart. Has spiraled above the previous high. 47.43.83 was the high on the 22nd of November. We're quite a bit above that now. We're at the high today is 48.07. So that doesn't have the double top aspect, but it does have this rising channel with what I call a Chapman wave inside track repellent zone. You can see every time in this weekly chart, the middle chart, the price got up into this very narrow little mini channel, like a green on the upside, because if it pierces that decisively, that's a big breakout. But if it stalls from the pink line to the green line, which has done so many times over the last 6-7 months, that's another sign that says, okay, it could pull back, but it is a rising channel. So far, we've got rising highs and rising lows, so that's good. So there's a real big divergence going on. The QQQ hasn't been able to accomplish the same thing, but it's pretty good so far. The high today is 404.58, and the all-time high is 408.71. So you can see what I'm talking about with the chances of these double tops coming in very close to one another.
Yes. Hey, Basil, let me ask you. So the chart before this, but the S&P in a monthly is only on a B, right? But
I don't know how to explain this.
No, that's all right. I get it. That's cool.
So it is amazing that because in the Chapman wave methodology, a buy signal that goes technically to a buy mode, and absolutely everything about the monthly chart is in a buy mode. It should go to at least four higher peaks to a peak.
No, which is cool. No, I can see that. Okay.
And that doesn't tell you that's. I use a completely separate thing to talk about the pullbacks, but can you imagine that we've gone from March of 2020 at 21.91, and we've only had, look at this minor little peak. It was only 40 cents away from an all-time high. And what we are looking at, and that's really important, is that within the context of monthly charts, one little peak from March 2020, and here we are, December of 2021, and we've only had one minor little peak. We're in leg B because we made a new all-time high in the month of December. And that says if you use just basic numbers, you've got, let's just say, no matter what happens, January does not make a new high. Whatever the high is in December, January does not make a new high. So that makes peak B. Then, no matter how deep you go down, it doesn't matter. You're going to have to make a leg C, which is higher than B. So that goes January. Then February starts leg C. Let's say March, you pull back for peak C. Then you get your leg D, and that takes you to April. And that makes it May before you can get an all-time high at the soonest. And it doesn't, once again, that doesn't tell you how high you're going to go. It just says that there should be higher highs to come over the next few months.
Well, that sounds like some fun.
Well, you know what I'm thinking? Because, you know, we keep talking about this rotation, and if you look at some of these stocks, they've been just absolutely hammered. I mean, the reason why the QQQs aren't leading anymore is you've got stocks like a DocuSign and so many, even a stock like Adobe, which was, it's a fantastic company. It was leading all the way. Even that's pulled back. Let's see, ADBE. Look, Adobe's pulled back very sharply from the 699.54 all-time high down to the 540s. It's now trading at 579. So there's a lot of work to be made up. So my suspicion is this, that the rotation continues, that we're going to see. Oh, is there something?
No, we can hear you. No, just keep going. We get you.
You can also see that within the different context of the IWM, which is, you know, this, that was leading once, and then it started to fail. And now it's from 244 high of November, it's pulled back all the way to the 209 level, it's the 223. So my suspicion is that the rotation will go on. And it's funny because I'm sure you're aware of this, just the retail with Amazon. Look, the RTH, which is the retail index, is acting completely different to the XRT, and the RTH has Amazon, and the XRT retail S&P doesn't. And that's the market. We're in a mixed market, very diverse. We've got to be very selective. And so far, we remain long the Dow.
And folks, very easy to get Basil's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content. Basil, you have a great one. Safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Are you having fun trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials up 112. NASDAQ is down 65. S&P's off 1.5. Let's go take a look at Bitcoin. So Bitcoin has been volatile. There's no doubt about that. Bottom line, this thing is swinging lower today by $3,100. So the lower end of this is going to get intriguing because what you had is this. Is that here? So watch this for a second. So when you look at streaks, trends, folks, right? Put this way. There we go. What I'm going to do here, I'm just taking the last leg down and just to see what type of a retracement you actually got. Yeah, we didn't even do a point. Well, that's close. No, last trend, we almost got to a 50%, so that's still a toss-up. Yeah, it's still a toss-up there. That being said, though, we're going to the lower end of it now. And the real question is going to be, is that we, the day that it had the spike, folks, okay, the spike got down to 42,200. It looks to me like this thing's going to 39. That's where this thing looks like it wants to go to. And if you break that, then it's going to be game at 29. So that's about as intense as you can get from, well, even from 68,000, I guess the 47,000 is pretty intense. There's no doubt about that. Inside the NDX 100 today, the strength versus the weakness. Strength is Activision. That's up 1.75%. You got Walgreens Boots up 1.3%. Exelon is up 1.3. Mercado Libre is up 1.3. Taken away from it. Dexcom is down a 6.6. You got Peloton up 3.5. If we look at Peloton, this is pretty intense, man. When, you know, we're just talking about with Basil about from highs to lows. Man, I mean, it's. Let me see this thing, man. This is. So if I put it on 5-year monthly, oof. 171 to 35, and it's probably going to 25. Let's see, $30 was when it stopped breaking topside. So this is like a classic, and this is definitely a classic if you want to see price and volume, folks, okay? Last time it had any volume was at $102, and then it went up additional 3 months, 4 months, actually. Went sideways for two, and then hit a high of 171. You're going to see this 171 on a monthly at 29 million shares. You came off of that with 43 and 53, and then you went lower with 97. You went higher with 29. This is the stuff you want to look at here. That you had a breakdown town. Oh, look at this. This is a shame. I didn't see this earlier. This is a monthly ABC structure down. Let's just see where this brings you. 171 is your A. Okay, so it was a 76 A to B, which gets you, that gets you to 50. You can see that in the monthly, it broke with conviction. So, bottom line, big deals. Madeira, M-O-D. This equity here also, bottom line is that, you know, it's taken, from highs to lows, it has taken quite a hit. There's no doubt about that. We take a look at this. What you're looking at is that we're at 242 and monthly. This, okay, so now watch this cool. This is cool, folks, okay? What you have here is this. Moderna has a high volume high at its high. So if you have an interest in this equity, this is where you want to start watching it. Not right here, I'm just saying in general, because I think this equity will actually get down to about 178. But at that level, it's going to be hard to break down into that level. That's the real bottom line. And when you have a high volume high, it wants to get hit again. And that baby up there is at 497. So you're talking about some real juice there. Inside the Dow Industrials out here today, the strength versus the weakness. Point-wise, what we have, you have United Health putting 21 positive points, Boeing 20, Disney 16, Home Depot 15, taken away from it. Salesforce minus 17, Nike 7, Microsoft 7. Let's go over to Disney and see if Disney is coming off this low, man. Disney's been on a one-way trip on the way down. Okay, so look at this is interesting. Okay, so you're taking a swing point out. Okay, so this is when you really want to pay attention to this. Now, look at this. So we're taking a swing out from 154.66. The swing had 10.2 million. We're 10.4. What that's saying, folks, that's saying that Disney is on the way back topside again. When you get, this is what I've found, and it's really cool. When you're in a holiday week and you know the volume is light and you have equities that can take a swing point out with volume on a holiday week, pay attention to it because that means someone's stepping in the middle of this thing. And let's see. So that's, put this on. First, I'm going to put it on a weekly. See how this looks. Okay, so on a weekly, you're down off of 203. You're at 153. So look at this, man. This I love these when they do this. They come right back to the breakout area. I wish it filled the gap. That's the only thing that didn't do, but guess what? What didn't do it, it didn't do it. It went to the 147. Okay, so it went to 142. If you want to see something, you know how I talk a lot about, oh my, that's it. That's what it did. You know, I talk a lot about the aspect of what equities like to do, folks, is this. you break out, and then when they come back, okay, they're either going to come back to the breakout area, or what they do is they come back to the highs of the lows of the breakout area. That's exactly what Disney did. Disney came to, well, hit 147.68 is the high of the breakout area of that week. Well, and we had volume there of 98 million. Well, we came back with 96 million. We got to 142, and then we closed at 146. Bottom line, that was the test. And now you're coming on the other side. Now let's go see if we can see any big monsters walking into Disney. And what I'm doing is I'm pulling up the folks that have to file if, in fact, they start moving in. Okay, this is going to be an interesting, okay? You got, it's not a lot. BlackRock is coming in with 268. Now, the BlackRock deal might be inside of a ETF structure, though. Here's a 12. That's 20. It's 1221. We have Franklin Resources. They sold 116,000. Here, let me go like this one. That one. That's easier. 9999. Here's 10. Who's that? That's Pictet Funds. And then BNP Paribas. There we go. USB. That's a Swiss bank. So they start coming into the equity. Not the last week, the last month they're coming into the equity. Your big seller out here. Look at this big seller. This is what destroyed. Wow, look at this, man. This is what destroyed this equity. It's SIG Holdings. They sold, as of the last time, I'm sure they sold the rest of this 4 million shares too. They sold 12 million on the last filing. That's a big number, man. And they had 4 million left. You had State Farm selling 3.7 million. They had 34 million left, so they might have kept selling. Not a bad setup, though. That's the real bottom line. It's important to understand that when you do have a vacation week, you have a weak stock as it was, it takes the swing point out, takes it out with volume. That's a new buyer. If it's not a new buyer that's coming on the market, it's someone that no doubt has a stamp on it. Dow Industrials right now up 122, NASDAQ is down 62, S&P's off 1. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at tfnn.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Bye.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's up 145, Nasdaq's down 58, S&Ps are up 1. And let's just look at this Dow chart for a second. So the Dow Industrials, I see, right next to it. Okay, so your all-time high is the 35,565. Right now we're at 36,565. The closing high is 432. Oh, that's gonna get interesting here. So what you're going to have out here today, folks, I suspect, is a closing high inside the Dow Industrials. We're up $1.47. Let me go look at the S&Ps here. They'll run this thing again, man. When you have trading weeks with, you know, holiday weeks, folks, you can just push it all over the place. Pushed it down earlier out here today. Whoops. Let me go. So we'll put this on a 10-minute. There we go. Okay, so you get some volume at the lows, no doubt about that. But yeah, it just punched it. You can see this. Look at this right here. You see the punch up on the bar. What happens when you're going to swing points, folks? If you get an acceleration of volume as you're going into the swing, it is a huge deal. And you can see right before we just went topside, right before the S&P just went from 4780 to 4785, you can see we went from 4775 to 4782. And see the push on volume? All these other bars here, these are all 10-minute bars. All the other bars were 9,300. This is right before it, 10,600. And then all of a sudden, bang, 17,190. That is what took it over the top of the consolidation. And bottom line is that now I suspect this thing can really run up to the 91 or something, you know, because that's just kind of how this baby shakes out. So it's going to be wild just watching this whole thing unravel. The thing that's amazing is looking at Basil's chart, that S&P is in a B. I'm telling you, that's like over the top. Amazon, let's go take a look at Amazon, because what we do have is that Amazon is teetering in this consolidation. It's up $24 today. We take a look at Amazon, you pull Amazon back. Amazon's been in a consolidation going all the way back to July of 2020. That's the bottom line. And when we take a look at the PE on Amazon at this price, this PE is still running at $41 to 1. So that's still a big number. And when I show you this, this is where this gets interesting, too. And, you know, Tommy had been talking about this yesterday. There's definitely people talking about it. Whoever got Oculus 2, folks, are talking about this deal with Facebook, with its Meta platforms now. What Meta did out here today, it goes to the top of its range, couldn't handle price. Bottom line, you're backing down. Well, you're up 117. It was high as 352 today, so it couldn't handle the swing point. More than likely, what you get there is that you'll get a pullback somewhere into like the 330 again with 347. And if that's the case, take a look at it, man, because what you do have with Facebook, watch this. This is pretty wild. When Tommy's bringing this up, this is Facebook going forward, it has a 24-1 PE. Right now, the PE is only 14-1. That is the total mind blower. So in Facebook's case, okay, so picture this too. So the way fundamentally you do this, so you're going to take what the PE is, right? And then you look to see, okay, what is the growth? Well, the bottom line is that Facebook is still growing by approximately 8% per year in the U.S., Canada, Europe. In Asia, they're growing by almost 12% a year. The whole year, the whole rest of the world, they're growing by 9% a year. So it's still a very large number. And what's intriguing, I suspect why it's trading at a very low multiple compared to the rest of these high flyers is that, you know, the bottom line is that where do we want to start? you know, whether it's antitrust, whether you want to start breaking up, you know, all of the above. That's what I expect that you have going there. You know, and if they have to basically tear apart some parts of it, I don't think Zuckerberg's worried about it, to tell you the truth. I think what they'll end up doing is that they could end up pushing off Instagram, pushing off Oculus, keeping Facebook there, and forget it. The rest is history, as they say. And they would be doing some big business. There's no doubt about that. We go take a look at the Netflix, NFLX. So Netflix out here today. Netflix is trading down 225. Put this on a weekly. Okay, so this came back to the breakout area also. The breakout area here is 556. We got down to 581. This is going to have to build more cars. That's the bottom line. This is, let me just look at this. So that, we don't have an ABC up. Let me put this on a monthly, actually. I'm going to put this on a monthly just to make sure we don't have an ABC up. Okay, so we took out the swing. The swing there had 140 million. No, it had 82 million. So, and this is where it recharges. So when you take a look at Netflix, you're going to see it's coming down to a breakout area again. That's where it recharges, and we'll see whether it can basically do the deal and go topside once again. Oil. Let's go take a look at the oil market out here. Oil right now, oil contract trading up 48 cents. You're at 76 bucks. And I suspect we're going to build some cars here. The oil's trying to get through the downdraft that was created out here on the 26th of November. That's where we went from 77 to 67 in a heartbeat. I expect you're going to go sideways a bit, and then you're going to go for the highs once again. That's how this baby's set up. ExxonMobil, XOM. What do you have with ExxonMobil? ExxonMobil right now, that's trading down 15 cents. That had rejected lower price at its gap. The gap was 57.82. We went to 57.96. That's a nice little deal also. And now, bottom line, we'll see whether it's going to consolidation. If these oil companies, folks, are in a consolidation, keep your eye on them in a big way. What I've found is this. Oil companies love to trade in a consolidation. And most times, the consolidation is very large. And if it's large, it's awesome. Because what ends up happening is that, you know, you don't have to be at the very top, the very bottom. I've traded them a couple times for years. And bottom line, they just did the exact same thing. I bet it was a year and a half or 2 years. And you can really not only have some good trades, it's identified. It's identified pretty clearly. And so when you get it right at the bottom, it's trending to the top. You get it right at the top, it's trending to the bottom. And when you get an equity that's only trading, you know, at $30 or $35, and it has a 7 to 8 point range, that is a sweet range, okay, for a $30 stock. That's what it comes down to. So pretty cool when you set that up. Dow Industrials right now trading up 114. We get the NASDAQ down 76. S&Ps are off 3. Gold. Gold is off 230 and King Dollar. King Dollar is up 62 ticks. Doesn't look to me like King Dollar is going to hold price out here. That's the bottom line. Notes and bonds still sideways moving. Note and bond market. All of these, of course, are going to get active big time next week. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We'll be right back.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
You might think that if you want to be successful at trading in the stock market, you're going to need a crystal ball. After all, it's impossible to predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at TFNN.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are you looking for a secured investment which pays you on a monthly basis? The Tiger First Mortgage Program may be the program for you. The best rate on a 5-year CD in the country right now, according to Bankrate.com, is paying 1% per year or $1,000 per $100,000 invested. The Tiger First Mortgage Program pays 7% per year, paid monthly, on secured, high-value, buildable properties in St. Petersburg, Florida. The investment is for 4 years, paying 7% per year, or $7,000 per $100,000 invested. Your investment is secured by high-value real estate in St. Petersburg, Florida. Your investment can be anywhere from $100,000 to $500,000. Do you want to make $1,000 per year on $100,000 invested, or $7,000 per year on a secured Tiger First Mortgage? The Tiger First Mortgage Program may be just the program for you. The Tiger First Mortgage Program pays 7% per year, paid monthly. For more information, you can call 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over and take a look at Crocs. Now, this has always been a big personality stock. The low is 58, the high is 183. Right now, this is trading out at 127. Let's put this on a weekly. This equity, if I'll bring this back further, and you're going to see how wild this equity can be. Okay, so this still has a high volume low from the last spike down at 115, so I expect it's going to go there. It has no volume at the highs. So, yeah, 102 is game on this, man. That's the bottom line. Now, watch this. I'm going to put this on a monthly, and you'll see something that's just amazing. So, look at this. 2006, it goes from $10 all the way up to $75. Then by 2009, it's back to $1.12. By 2011, it's up to $32. By 2017, it's at $5.60. By 2020, it's at $43. And, well, okay, hold one second. What's that? That's January of 2020, it's at $43. March, it's at $8. And then it just never stopped. It went from $8. That's what Crocs like to do. But I would not be buying Crocs, that's for sure. Bottom line, I'm talking about the equity. This has, let's see, February 23rd is the next time they come out with numbers. And imagine, this still, numbers are still good, man. They're doing $2.3 billion and bringing $7.57 to the bottom line. Pretty amazing. They're contracting, though. In the United States, they're still growing by 7% a year. The worldwide, though, you're contracting by 14% per year. So that, no doubt, is one monster number. Always remember, folks, the bear can claw your heart out, the bull can run you over, and thank God, there's always another trade. Health, happiness, and prosperity. Have a great night, folks. Have a safe night. Have a great new year. We're going to be kicking it into 2022. Come back and visit Tommy tomorrow morning. Kicks us off 9 a.m. Great show. Ram! Go get him, folks.